Since logarithms are exponents, and there are rules for exponents, there are corresponding rules for logarithms, which we see here below in red, that can be used to expand or condense logarithms. For the product property of logarithms, if we have the log of x times y, we can write this as a sum of two logs, where we have log x plus log y. If we're taking the log of a quotient, we can write it as a difference of two logs. So the log of x divided by y is equal to log x minus log y. So if we have a quotient, we have a difference of two logs. If we have a product, we have a sum of two logs. And then for the power property of logarithms, if we have log of x to the nth power, we can write this as n times log x. So if we want to expand log base 2 of x to the fourth times the square root of y to the fifth, we need to recognize this first as a product, which means we can write this as a sum of two different logarithms. But before we do this, we do want to rewrite the square root of x to the fifth in exponent form. And since we have a square root where the index is 2, we can rewrite this as log base 2 of x to the fourth times, this would be y to the 5/2. And again, now because we have a product, we can write this as a sum of two logs. So we'd have log base 2 of x to the fourth plus, again because we have a product, log base 2 of y to the 5/2. And now to expand this one more time, we can apply the power property of logarithms given here, which means we can take the exponents and move them to the front so they're coefficients. So we can move this 4 here to the position of the coefficient in front. We can move this 5/2 to the front so it's also the coefficient. So we'd have 4 log base 2 of x plus 5/2 times log base 2 of y. This would be considered the expanded form of the given logarithm. Looking at our second example, we have natural log of x to the third times y to the second divided by z to the fifth. So we'll do this in stages. Let's first deal with this quotient here. Remember, if we have the log of a quotient, we can write it as a difference of two logs. So this is equal to the natural log of the numerator, which is x to the third, y to the second, minus, because we have a quotient, natural log z to the fifth. And now looking at the first log, because we still have a product here, we can write this log, or expand this log, into a sum of two logs. We'd have natural log x to the third plus natural log y to the second, and then we still have minus natural log z to the fifth. And now we can apply the power property of logarithms, which means we can move these exponents to the front of the logarithms. So to expand this further, we have 3 natural log x plus, this would be 2 natural log y minus 5 natural log z. And again, this would be considered the expanded form of the given logarithm. Okay, we'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.